Hello, my dear students. Здравствуйте, мои дорогие студенты. Меня зовут Вероника. My name is Veronika, and I am a professional Russian teacher. And yes, of course, I am a Russian native speaker. And today, at this Russian lesson, I would like to continue teaching you everything you need to know about Russian names. I already made a video about male names that are popular in Russia, and today, obviously, I would like to continue and to make another video about female names that are popular in Russia. And I would like to start from the very international name Maria. In English, you say Maria, and in Russian, we say more soft. We say Maria. Where you see the red color, there is the stress. And now let's talk about diminutives in Russian language. So first of all, the very popular diminutive from the name Maria, Maria, is Masha. Masha. It's very neutral. You can use this almost in every situation if you know this person quite well. If you are a colleague, if you are a friend or a family member, you can call Maria as Masha in Russian culture. And yeah, if you already watch my videos quite a long time, you know that I have a cat and her name is Marusia. Marusia derives from Maria. So the full name in the passport of the Russian person is Maria and the nickname is Marusia. Yeah. But many foreigners, when they hear that I call my cat Marusia, they think that Marusia is related to Russia, Russia, Russia. No, there is no connection with my country, with Russian people at all. It just derives from the name Maria. And also another nickname is Manya. Manya also derives from the name Maria. Or you can say Mashenka, Mashenka. This is a very nice form that, yeah, for example, mother can use for her daughter, or an older sister can use this for a little sister, Mashenka. We use this when we want to show our affection, our love, yeah. And also, kind of very similar form is Mashulia. Mashulia. And I forgot to write, but also we have a very beautiful form, nickname in Russian language. It is Rusia. Rusia. It comes from Maria. You see that the root is totally different. Maria, and then we made Rusia. Yeah, I hope that you understand. And by the way, if you think that my Russian lessons are interesting and useful and helpful for you, you can support my channel and send me a donation. Yeah, and let's continue our Russian lesson. Name number two that I chose for this Russian lesson is Olga. Olga, it's kind of international name too. I think that in German language and in some Scandinavian language, you have very similar name that is Helga. In Russian, we say Olga. I wonder if you have this name in your mother tongue. Let me know in the comments below. And the short name is Оля. Оля. That's quite obvious. But there is one more nickname in Russian language that is not so obvious. And it is Ося. Ося. Yeah. Also, if you want to show your love, your affection, your warm attitude to the person, you can say Оленька, Оленька. But here you need to pay attention to the Russian phonetics, because Оленька is written with Е in the second syllable, but Russian people pronounce this name in Russian language as Оленька with an E in the middle. Because this Е is an unstressed weak position without stress, and we pronounce, according to the Russian phonetics law, we pronounce this Е as I. Оленька. Yeah, the same. Also, you can use the form Олечка. Олечка. It's nice diminutive form from the name Ольга. And also there is one more very beautiful, in my opinion, diminutive Alinionak. Actually, Alinionak is a baby deer. You know this, like Bambi, yeah, this animal. Yeah, but here you need to pay attention again to the Russian phonetic system, because O in unstressed position you pronounce like A. That's why we say in Russian not Olenionak, but Alinionak, yeah? Here we have three weak positions here, yeah, without stress. That's why E unstressed we pronounce as E, and O unstressed we pronounce as A. That's why in Russian language we say Alinionak. Yeah, I hope you understand, but if there is something unclear in my explanation of this topic, just let me know in the comments below, and I'm happy to try to explain one more time. And there is one more nickname, Olika. Olika. Here you need to pay attention to the softness, yeah, because in Russian language we have two different L sounds. We have hard one, L, like in the word stol or stool. And we have another one, very soft, that is palatalized, and it is kind of with a very short E, yeah? Olka, olka. I hope that you can hear the difference. And let's talk about the name number three. That is very popular in Russia, and it is the name Anna. Anna. And let's talk about nicknames that we use in Russian language. Number one is Anya. Anya. So you see that the full name Anna is hard in Russian language, yeah? And the nickname Anya is soft. Anya. But be very careful, do not say Anna or Anya. It's Anya. Very, very short, small E, kind of ghost E, yeah? Anya. Or another form that I do really like, Asya. Asya. It sounds so elegant and sophisticated, in my opinion. I do love this form, Asya. Yeah. And another one is Anichka. Anichka. Pay attention to this Е in the middle. We write Е, but we pronounce it as E because it is in unstressed weak position. Анечка we write, and we say Анечка, yeah? And this form you can use for Anna, if for Anna, if you are in a very good relationship, if you do really like this girl, and you want to show your warm attitude, you can say Anichka. Another one is Anyuta. Anyuta. Also, you can use this for a girlfriend, for a daughter in Russian language. Yeah, it means that you want to show your affection, kinda. And another one, Anka. Anka, it's quite neutral. You can use this in any kinda situation when you know this person. You can use this in a negative situation, like what a rude girl, Анька, какая грубая девчонка, Анька. You can say this, or you can say this is my friend, my best friend, Анька. Это моя лучшая подружка, Анька. So it just depends on the context where you use this diminutive in Russian language, but it can be used in negative or in a positive situation. Yeah, just depends on the context, yeah. Okay, and I have some more pages to discuss, and there is a very beautiful Slavic name. All these names before, they were kinda international. You can hear them in English language or in French, in Spanish, in Italian, but Svitlana is a Slavic name. And the root in this beautiful Slavic name is Svet. Svet means light or shine. For example, when you say the sun is shining, you say солнце светит. Светит. It gives light to the earth, to the planet, kinda, yeah? So Svetlana means a light woman that has inner light, kinda, inside of her soul, yeah? That's why I do really love this name. And I think that in Italian language you have kind of very similar name, Chiara, and in English maybe Sierra, yeah? So yeah, Svetlana, if you have something similar in your mother tongue, just let me know in the comments below. Very interesting for me. And their nickname of this Slavic name, Svetlana, in Russian language is Sveta. Sveta. Pay attention here again to the Russian phonetic system, because Svetlana, the first syllable is a non-stressed position. That's why this E we pronounce as I. Svetlana. But when we make a nickname in Russian, Sveta, this E we pronounce like E because it is under the stress. Sveta. Or you can say Svetka. Svetka. And another form that I do really like is Svetik. Svetik. And many foreigners who learn Russian, many of my students, they are very, how to say, confused by the ending of this name, because Svetik finishes with a K, with a consonant. And according to the Russian grammatical rules, if you have a consonant in the end, it must be a masculine gender, yeah? But it's still a feminine name. We use this, Svetik, for a Russian woman or a Russian girl. So now you know this trick of the Russian language. And yeah, if you want to show your warm attitude, you can use the name Svetochka, Svetochka, or totally different root in Russian language, you can say Lana, Lana. It derives from the second part of the name Svetlana, obviously, yeah? Okay, and if you want, by the way, I can make a video about your name. You can type, you can write for me in the comments below this video your name, and I will try to find something similar in Russian language, and I think that's interesting, yeah? You can try. And let's talk about the next name. It is Елизавета. Елизавета. It's the name, for example, of the Queen Elizabeth. Yeah. So in English you say Elizabeth. In Russian we say Елизавета. And the short name is Лиза. Лиза or Лиска. Лиска in Russian language. Here, most probably you already heard that we write Лизка, but we pronounce Лиска. Yeah, we say С. Yeah. Why? Because we see this Russian consonant К. Yeah, Лиска. And this Z letter stands in front of this К. That's why we have to say in this position not Z, but С. Лиска. Or a very nice form, if you like this person, this Лиза, you can say Лизочка. Лизочка. Or another form is Лизонька. Лизонька. And if you listen carefully to my explanation, you already know that this O in the middle should be pronounced as A. Because obviously, again, it is in an unstressed weak position. So you say Лизочка, Лизонька, not Лизочка, as many foreigners who try to speak Russian want to say this. No, no, no. Now you know that this is a mistake, this is a trap. Это ловушка, you should say. And yeah, let's talk about Анастасия. Анастасия, what a beautiful name for a princess, for a queen. So, in English, you pronounce this name as Anastasia. And I think that I do like the English version. For my ears, it sounds more pleasant. Anastasia. Yeah, in Russian we say Anastasia. And the nickname from the Russian name Anastasia is Nastya. Nastya. So we just skip this A, yes, and say Nastya. Or you can say Nastinka. Nastinka. Many foreigners, they laugh and they say your short nickname, kinda, your nickname actually should be shorter than the full name, but in Russian, the nickname is longer than the full name. It's actually true. I do not know why do we do this. Yeah, but we say Nastinka, or you can say Nastyusha. Nastyusha sounds very sweet for me. I like this. And you can say just Stasia. Stasia. Yeah, I think it's very beautiful. And maybe you have a very similar nickname in English, Stacy, or it's separate name. Just let me know. Yeah, I like this. Stasia. And also we have the form in Russian language Nastyona. Nastyona. And now many teenagers, they know English language quite well. We start to learn English when we are kids, even in kindergarten, yeah. And many teenagers, they call themselves as Nesty Nastya. It sounds very similar. Yeah, Nesty is English word and Nastya is Russian nickname. And they think it sounds very cool. Nesty Nastya, yeah. Okay. And now let's talk about the name Yelena. Many foreigners who learn Russian or who just live in Russia, who came to Russia for some traveling, they say not Yelena, but Elena. It's a mistake. If it should be Elena, we should write it with E. Yeah? Elena. But this is Yelena. Don't forget about this short Y sound in the beginning of this Russian name. Actually, I know that this name is Greek, not Russian, but it's super popular in Russia. We have so many Yelenas here in Russia. So I just included this name to this list, yeah. And the nickname is Lena, Lena, or just Lenka. You see that Russian language adores this suffix k, Lenka. Or if you want to show again your love, your warm attitude, or maybe gratitude even, you can say Lenochka, Lenochka. And more familiar, quite informal option is Lenok, Lenok. You can use this for a friend or for a colleague if you are in a really good relationship, yeah, Lenok. And pay attention again to Russian phonetics here, because this year we should pronounce as E, Lenok, yeah. Or another form, which is quite funny, is Linusia, Linusia. Yeah, and pay attention again to this form, Lenok. It finishes with a K, it finishes with a consonant, and it looks like a masculine name, but actually it's a name for a woman. The same we had already and discussed with the name Svetik, right? Svetik. Okay, we have two more names to discuss. And yeah, there is a name Tatyana. Tatyana. I do love this name. And the short option, short nickname that is popular in Russia is Tanya. Tanya. Or Tanya. Tanya. Here, you need to know that this N in the middle is soft. So do not say Tanka. It sounds like you are in a tank. Yeah, you know. You should say Tanya with a small, small ghost E. Yeah, Tanya. Or there is another funny option. I do like this option. Tata. Tata or Tati. Tati. Tati sounds a little bit more English or American vibe, I think. Yeah. And another Russian suffix that is very popular in Russian language is Tanyusha. Tanyusha. You can use this option if you, again, like this person. Tanyusha. And Tanichka. Tanichka. Yeah. It shows your warm attitude again. Okay, so Tatiana, this was a full name that you use in a passport, yeah? And there is the last name that I wanted to discuss at this Russian lesson, and it is Natalia. Here you need to know that in Russian language we have two different names, Natalia with a soft sign and Natalia with a E, yeah? When you say them, that's not a lot of difference. Natalia, Natalia, yeah? Even for Russian people, we do not hear the difference well. But that's a big mistake, because if you change the soft sign or E vowel in a document, it's another person, right? So you need to be super careful if you fill the documents. And if you are Natalia, normally it's a big, big mistake, opportunity for making mistakes, kinda. So the short option of the name Natalia in Russian language is Natasha. Natasha. Look, it sounds for me like a Japanese name because there are lots of open syllables. Natasha. Sounds like Japanese language, yeah? What do you think? Isn't it? Or you can say Nata, Nata, sounds nice for me, or Nati, Nati, it's kinda fashionable, Nati, yeah? And another form that I do not like, another funny nickname in Russian is Tusya, Tusya. For me it sounds weird and not rude, but silly, I don't like this form. Another one is Natacha. Natacha. It's quite rude. If a woman is elegant and beautiful, sophisticated, you cannot call her Natacha. But if she smokes, if she drinks alcohol, if she dances like crazy, I don't know, and behaves like a man, you can call her Natacha. It means like, yeah, she is too strong. And if you like Natalia, you can call her Natashenka. This is what mother can say, for example, to her daughter or to her sister, to her female friend. Natashenka. This is nice form. Okay, my dear Russian learners, I hope that this Russian lesson was useful and interesting for you again. And you know what you need to do if you want to thank me. You can hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. It makes me happy when I see that the amount of my subscribers is growing. It makes me really, really happy every day, every morning when I get up and I just scroll up my page and I'm checking the amount. It makes me really happy. Thank you for watching. Спасибо за просмотр. Thank you for all the time that you spend with me here, with me learning Russian language. And yes, if you want to support my channel, you can hit the like button and subscribe to my channel and leave me any comment. And of course, you can send me a donation. You will find the links for donations in the first comment below this video. Спасибо за просмотр. Увидимся скоро. До встречи. See you soon. Пока-пока. Bye-bye.